Hi, and welcome back to our series on Hello CISO. This time around, we're going to be looking at phishing attacks, and in particular, AI advancements in phishing attacks. Now, AI in phishing is something that's been around for a good couple of decades already, but is getting particularly interesting in more recent times. The problem of phishing is just getting worse and worse, with more phishing sites, more phishing emails, and attackers becoming increasingly sophisticated at such a rate that we as humans alone can't keep up. So we turn to the machines and we turn to AI. When it comes to the developments in AI and phishing, we're going to talk about three different areas today. The first one being advancements in phishing detection of emails using AI. The second one is going to be how AI can help detect phishing websites. And thirdly, we're going to turn things around and look at how attackers can use AI to make their phishing attacks more effective than ever. Let's start with using AI to detect phishing emails. Now, this is something that we've had for a good couple of decades already. In fact, Spam Assassin dates back to about 2001. So in many ways, this is very familiar territory. One way phishing filters learn is to be trained by humans. So when you flag an email as a potential phish, that feeds back into the engine, which helps identify what a phishing email looks like. This is one of the ways that we've trained spam filters for many years now. Then there's Bayesian inference, which is a much more intelligent way of learning as the machines update the probability for a hypothesis of whether or not the email is spam and possibly phishing. So this is AI working to identify the typical patterns of what constitutes a phishing attack sent via email and getting smarter and smarter as time progresses and more data is fed into the engine. Now this is great because the spam filters get smarter and smarter over time. That in turn means the attackers need to up their game in order to respond to not just smarter AI in things like spam filters, but also more savvy users. Now this in turn has led to a growth in what we refer to as spearfishing. So very targeted attacks tailored at individuals within organizations. Phishing attacks of that nature are harder for the machines to identify because it's no longer a mass shotgun style approach with a heap of emails of a very generic nature. These are often very carefully crafted, personalized, targeted at that one person, perhaps that one high-value target within an organization. And that's a much trickier problem to address, even with AI. In a case like spearfishing, good spearfishing, you're probably not going to identify that with the machine alone. It's more likely to be a human that picks up on that. So the old value proposition of training users still exists, even when we have machines and even when we have modern interpretations of AI. But of course, technology can help too. And a really good example of this is password managers. I know for me, when I go to a website and I want to fill my credentials in to log into the site, my password manager will make sure that it only fills in credentials for the website with the correct domain that matches what I have stored in my password manager. If I go to a phishing site, even if the domain is almost identical, bar, say, one character that my eye might not even pick up, my password manager won't fill the credentials in. So that's a great example of how technology can still help us avoid even spear phishing attacks. But getting back to AI detecting phishing emails for a moment, one of the paradoxes we have here is that a lot of this is done on the server side. So this is where a lot of the AI processing power exists. Now, the paradox is that if it's done on the server side, then at the server level, at the mail provider level, there needs to be the ability to inspect email contents. The paradox is that then has a privacy implication. So we see organizations like Apple trying to push that phishing email detection back to the client where the email is expected to be read, as opposed to the server. So we do have to try and balance the privacy and security implications of AI-based phishing detection. The overall picture is like so many other parts of InfoSec. It's an arms race. On the one side, we have the AI being used to detect phishing emails and phishing websites. We've got humans being trained to identify the same things. And on the other side, we have the attackers getting increasingly sophisticated, trying to evade those processes, both the humans and the machines. And so the arms race continues. Let's move on and talk about detecting phishing websites, because just as you can train AI to detect phishing emails, it can also be trained to detect websites which are attempting phishing attacks. For example, AI can be trained to look at everything from the URL to any certificates issued to the website, to, of course, the contents of the website, so what's actually on the page. Phishers are well and truly accustomed to adjusting the structure of their phishing pages to try and evade technologies such as AI. We've seen them evolve over time. Years ago, it used to be that phishers would stand up an entire representation, a replication, if you will, of the intended website, let's say someone's bank. These days, it's very much focused on a single page, let's say the login page. All they need to do is just replicate that one page and adjust it enough such that phishing detection, the AI, can't identify it as a malicious page. Sometimes these phishing pages are highly transient, lasting only days or in some cases perhaps only hours, either before a host pulls it offline, or in many cases, it'll be something like Google Safe Browsing has now classified it as a phishing site. And anyone going to that page gets that great big red interstitial page warning about the fact there's a phishing site behind it. But just as quickly as these pages can disappear, they can also reappear. They stand up again on compromised hosts, on new domains, perhaps on addresses that look very much like the intended website that they're meant to replicate. One area where phishing websites have evolved in recent years is via the use of TLS certificates, and in particular by implementing HTTPS on the web page. Still to this day, browsers indicate websites served over HTTPS with positive visual indicators. As of today, we see a little padlock on browsers such as Google Chrome, but it was only a couple of years ago where it would literally say secure in the browser as well. Now, this is very attractive to an attacker, because when a victim literally sees the word secure in their browser, their confidence level in the legitimacy of the page they're on goes up. The rise and rise of free certificates via the likes of Let's Encrypt have made it trivial for attackers with malicious websites to get those positive visual indicators on the browser. The padlock, in days gone by, the word secure, all of these things helping the phisher create this air of authenticity for their phishing page. Of course, many of us know that secure never meant the site was trustworthy. It was never meant to imply trust. It only meant that your connection to the server was encrypted. Now, the third area to look at, which I flagged at the beginning of this episode, is AI on the attacker's side. Just as we as defenders can use AI to identify phishing emails and phishing websites, attackers can use AI to increasingly make their phishing attacks more sophisticated. Of course, attackers are going to use AI themselves. It's more ubiquitously available than what it ever was before, and it's becoming better and better at crafting stories. It makes a lot of sense for them, just as it makes a lot of sense for us defending systems. In fact, there's a story here just from a few years ago about a Japanese AI program writing a short novel that almost won a literary prize. Now, if we can get robots to write novels that look like they're written by normal humans, what do you reckon the chances are of a robot writing phishing emails and phishing web pages that look like legitimate versions? We're already seeing white papers around how neural networks can greatly improve the effectiveness of phishing attacks. And that should come as no surprise. As computers get more intelligent, AI gets more efficient, we're going to see it increasingly used for malicious purposes. Wrapping up, phishing detection isn't a battle that can be won. It is a continual arms race. It's a little bit like saying, can I win the battle against my nails, or do I have to keep clipping them? Yeah, you're going to have to keep clipping them for the rest of your life. This is the arms race between your fingers and your nail clippers. This is a fact of life. As time progresses and we see more AI on both sides, we're going to see more of the machines fighting the machines. This is going to be the nature of combating phishing attacks. One advantage, though, that we do have as defenders is that we don't need to fool people. Attackers will continue to need to trick people into falling for phishing attacks. So we can tackle that not just with the machines, but, as already mentioned, by training the humans as well. A two-pronged approach. So how long will it take before phishing emails can successfully pass the Turing test? So we won't be able to tell the difference between a phishing email written by an attacker versus one written by an attacker's code. If you've enjoyed this video as part of the Hello CISO series, then please give it a like and subscribe to the 1Password YouTube channel for more videos like this.